They are supposed to provide us offices. We are members of parliament. We are not ordinary people.
Last week, as parliament started the third session, government, opposition and leadership of independent MPs made changes in both membership and leadership of the 15 sectoral committees of parliament, whose lifespan lasts for 1 year. The changes saw four committee chairpersons dropped and several vice chairpersons who are replaced by majorly fresh MPs.
I beg to designate the following to the Committee on Public Service and Local Government. Honorable Ojara Martin Mapenduzi, Chairperson.
Committee on Health, the following membership I designate. The Honorable Dr. Nandagire Christine N. from Bukoma Simbi North.
However, the Speaker brought it to the attention of the House that the dropped chairperson have refused to vacate offices of their successors. Among directed victims of last week's reshuffle to vacate offices, she also called for immediate handover of office to the new guards for smooth running of Parliament.
We've had changes, especially in leadership. I request that an immediate handover takes place, especially for offices. I have been told some leaders don't want to leave the offices. Can we have immediate handover?
However, some outgoing committee chairpersons have denied claims by the Speaker, saying their predecessors are nowhere to receive office.
We are supposed to do the handover officially. It's not a matter of which must be on the floor. It is an internal administration matter that should be done between the incoming and the outgoing. But in any case, for my case, I haven't even seen the person. My other chairman, I'm aware, he wanted to hand over and called the other one who is not in the country.
Robert Kasolo, the outgoing vice chairperson of the Physical Infrastructure Committee, wondered why they are forced to vacate offices before they are allocated alternative office space that they are entitled to as MPs.
They are supposed to provide us offices. Not yet.
But the vice chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee of Rules and Privileges, Father Charles Onen, has condemned the behavior of some committee chairpersons who are elusive on surrendering offices.
People have been holding certain offices. Whenever time comes for them to leave that office, they don't want to leave. And that is a total abuse. We always say the president has overstayed in power, we need to change, make a change and the rest. But now those who are advocating, legislators themselves, they don't want to leave the offices where they have been worked. Because sectorial committee and also standing committee chairpersons, those offices, they are rotational, not rotational, they are periodical.
The recent changes saw the Defence and Internal Affairs Committee chairperson, Rosemary Nyachikongoro, lose seat for Wilson Kajwenje, the MP Nyabushozi, Finance Committee chairperson, Dr. Kefa Chiwanuka, replaced by Amos Kankunda, MP Rampara, David Karubanga, the outgoing chairperson of the Physical Infrastructure Committee, was replaced by Dan Atwijukire, MP Kazoo County. Others are Godfrey Onzima, the chairperson of the Public Service and Local Government Committee, who was dropped from Martin Ojara Mapenduzi, among others. But we have learnt that none of the outgoing chairpersons has surrendered office to their successors. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.